Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to the geography class. Today I'm going to teach you about the population dynamics, the second chapter. So let's see here. As you can see here on your screen, the chapter is given, the population dynamics. And first of all, I will explain you about the meaning of population dynamics. So all of you know that the population nowadays is not only a problem but also a solution. Problem, how? As the population is increasing day by day, it is growing, and the growth rate is so fast, and it is creating a problem. But at the same time, population is the greatest resource. Yes, population is the greatest resource, and without population, we can't utilize any of the natural resource. So, in this chapter, we are going to study about the detailed study about the population. So, first of all, let us see about the population dynamics. What does this chapter population dynamics means? The population, all of you know, the meaning of the population, the people. And the word dynamics usually is a topic in mathematics. Now, dynamics means anything which is increasing, ever increasing. And same thing you can find with the population. The population of the world is ever increasing. The population is not going down, but this population is ever increasing. And many of the countries, this overpopulation is creating a problem. Well, first of all, we are going to see some main headline, the most important things about the population. So let's see here, as on your screen you can see here, some of the point is written here. First of all, the population actually is the greatest resource of the world. The people are the greatest resource of the world. Second is, the population actually is a cheap manpower. Example, you can find there are so many countries which attracts many countries, many companies. And many countries actually they want to invest in those countries. Example of India and China, Bangladesh, example of Brazil, Russia. Now these countries are not only big countries, but they are having a very, very big population. And this population, first of all, it provides a cheap labor. We call it cheap manpower. And you can find this thing, this demand is ever increasing. Some of the countries where the population is less, and especially the skilled population, the people who actually are skilled, who have actually developed themselves, who have actually developed some important skills. Now they have a great demand. Like example in America, in so many European countries also, in the field of software, in information technology, in many industries. Now there is a great demand of the people who have developed a skill in a specific field, like software engineer, like so many different scientists, different scholars, those who have gained a special skill, developed themselves in some specific skill. So this is how actually the population, it provides the manpower, and this is one of the most important thing about the population. Now second thing is, the population, it utilizes and exploits the other natural resources. There are some countries where the population is less, and because of that, they are not able to utilize the natural resources. Example you can find in Middle East, in the Gulf countries like in Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, in UAE, and there are so many countries like Qatar, Oman. Now there is a great demand of the people from Asia, the skilled people from India, from Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. Now why these people, they used to go to these countries? Because they lack the skilled labor, the people who are skilled in some specific fields. Now all of you know the Middle East, actually there it is very, very rich. All these countries are very, very rich, especially in petroleum. But the thing is, to work in these petroleum companies, to extract the petroleum from the different well, they need the manpower, they need the cheap labor. And these cheap labors are available from the countries like our country India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Malaysia, Indonesia. These all countries, they are having a densely populated. All these countries, they are having a big population, large population. And this is how these people are hired by these countries. So another thing is, the man, through his knowledge, through his intellect, by the help of the skill which has been developed by these people, now we have the power. Actually, the human beings, we are having problem, sorry, we are having the one power by which actually we can transform any natural objects into valuable resources. So this is only given to us, means the human beings. So this is how population is so important. Now the next topic we are going to see about the distribution and density of population. But first of all, I will explain you about the density of population. What do you mean by the density of population? Now here you can find, to find out the population density, first of all we have to take the total population of any country or any region or any state or city, and then it is divided by the total land area. So suppose if we have to find out the population density of any country like India, so first of all we will take the total area of our country India, and then we divide it by the, first of all we will take the total population of our country India, and we divide it by the total land area of the country. So this is how we get the population density of our country India. Same way, suppose if we have to find out the population density of our city Gorakhpur, how we will find out the population density? So first of all we will take the total population of our city, and we will divide it by the total land area of our city Gorakhpur. So this is how the population density can be taken out of any country or state or maybe any region or cities or maybe village. So this is how the population density can be defined as, population density is the measurement of the number of people in an area. Means the number of the specific people, the number of people in area, that is called population density. Just let me just make it easier. Population density can be very easily, I can be defined as the number of people living in 1 square kilometer area. So this is a population density. So the population density, it tells us that whether the country or that region they are having, they are densely populated or sparsely populated, or maybe moderately populated. Now next is, we are going to see about the distribution of population. So you can find here are three main zones of population distribution. Means the population all over the world can be kept into three groups. Now, what are these groups? Let's see here. The first one is the densely populated regions. Second is the moderately populated regions. And third is the sparsely populated regions. So, first of all, we are going to see about the densely populated regions. So, now, in the densely populated region, you can see there are so many countries. Example, if you just take an example of China and India, Bangladesh, or maybe Pakistan, Malaysia or Indonesia. So we all know these countries are densely populated. So let's see here some of the countries which are densely populated. Example, already I told you some of the name, like China, Japan, India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand. So all these countries, if you'll find, these countries are highly populated, very densely populated. They are having a very high population, big population. So even you can find in India, our country India, we are having 2.4% of the world's land, but we are having 17.31% of total population of the world. Means we occupy only 2.4% of the total world's land. From the total area of the world, India occupies only 2.4% of the land. But because we are having a very big population, and in our country we are having 17.31% of the total population of the world. So if you compare it with the land is 2.4% of the total world land, and population is 17.31%. So you can just imagine in our country, about the population in our country, how big population is there in our country. Now, next example, we can take example of China. All of you know about the China. China is a big country, but China also, same way like India, they are having also a very big population. And together, actually, if you'll find, there is one data I would want to show you about the population. I will show you afterwards. But just one example, if you take example of China and India, they together constitute, about the very big population of the total world. I will show you the data, right? But first of all, now let me just show you the other zones also. Let's finish it and then I will show you the one data where the population is shown continent wise. So we'll see this thing afterwards. Now here again, so we have already seen only in the East Asia. This one example we have seen about the densely populated region in Asia, and that is only in the East Asia. Now let's see here the some example of the densely populated countries in Europe. Now in Europe also, if you'll find, population density is very high. In fact, if you study the history, in the 18th century you will find they were facing a population explosion problem. Means the population was so large that so many problems was faced by these countries. And what happened? So they started finding out the new land. This was a time when the North America, South America, then the southern part of Africa, Australia, New Zealand, all these new lands and continents were discovered. And large number of people from Europe, they have migrated to these continents like North America, South America, in Australia. Now you'll find these all are the very big continent, and you will find there a large number of people living in these continents, they are the Europeans. So, but still you will find in Europe, the population density is very high. Now the countries like UK, UK means United Kingdom, France, Italy, Denmark, Holland, Germany, Belgium, European Russia, Ukraine, all these countries actually are very densely populated. Now why here the population is so dense? If you'll find here, there are so many factors. Example, they are highly industrialized and commercially very, very advanced countries. Now because of this, if you'll find at present, you will find there the large number of people from Asia even. Large number of people from India you will find in UK, means in Britain, even in France, Spain, in Italy, people from Pakistan, Bangladesh. Now why these people, they have migrated there and they have already settled there? Because these countries are highly industrialized and commercially, they are very, very advanced. So, well, now let's see here some more actually region of the densely populated regions. So, now we are going to see some places in United States of America. All of you know, United States of America also is a big country and it is also a it has also having a large population. Now, usually in United States of America, means USA, if you will see, it is a big country, but mostly you will find the population actually is very densely populated in only some areas. Like example, if you will find one example, because in the previous classes already you have studied about the North America. So, already you know about it. You have studied about the Great Lakes. The five lakes together, they form the so big region of lakes. They are called Great Lakes, if you remember. Now the area around the Great Lake, this region is the most densely populated region. Now you'll find actually the Great Lakes, the northern part of Great Lake, now this region actually in the northern part, now this region is bordered by Canada, and the southern part of these Great Lakes, they are bordered by United States of America. So they share the common boundary between this lake, well, and it is utilized and used by the both the countries together. Now this is a very, very big lake. They will find so many very, very, very famous cities, like you may have knowing about Detroit, Toronto. So these cities actually, they are found here only. Montreal. Some of the names I'm not able to remember, but as you'll see it. So this is the region. The region around the Great Lake is highly populated region. Now, other parts of the USA, if you'll find, population is not so densely populated. Now we are going to see about the moderately populated region. Now, the moderately populated regions are found, there are very specific regions can be seen. Now, example, in North America, in USA and Canada, you must be knowing about the prairies, the temperate grassland. So this is the region actually which is moderately populated. Then another is the Eastern Europe. Now Eastern Europe is far from the coast. They experience a very hard climate, and climatic conditions are very extreme. And so here also population density is moderate. Next is the southern Russia and Ukraine. Now this whole region actually is covered by the steppes, again the temperate grassland. So this is also a moderately populated region. Now in India, if you'll find India, usually we know that India is having a very, very big population. But even in India, if you'll find the whole Deccan Plateau, they are moderately populated. The Plateau region, the Deccan Plateau in Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, it is a very big plateau. And this is also a moderately populated region. Now, another one is the Plateau of Western and Central Asia. Western and Central Asia means the whole big plateau and the Himalayan region. If you find the Himalaya is surrounded by the plateau. There is a Tibetan plateau and there are the large plateaus covering it. It just extend up to Iranian plateau. Well, so when you will study about the Asia, and in that you will study about the physical division. So this whole Himalayas and all this big plateau region, they are called Central and the Central Asia, part of Central Asia. So this region also, Central Asia, it is moderately populated. Another thing is the Pampas, all of you know, temperate grassland in Argentina. Brazilian plateau, that is in Brazil, they are also moderately populated. Wells actually is the region of the temperate grassland. In fact, the temperate grassland there in the South Africa is known as Wells. Now this is also a moderately populated region. Next is Australia. Australia is a big continent. Well, it is a country, but together with so many islands, it forms one continent first of all, and in that the whole Australia is one country. Now Australia, also if you find Australia is having a big, large part of Australia actually is covered by the desert and plateau. More than 70% part of Australia is either desert or either plateau. So you will find the population actually is found in pockets, means population usually is, most of the population is found in the coastal areas. And so Australia also is moderately populated region. Now we are going to see about the sparsely populated regions. Now which areas, now all of you know, where the population is very, very less, means where you can find the people in numbers, just very, very few in number. Now you can find example, you can take the example of all the tropical deserts like Sahara Desert, Kalahari Desert in Africa, Arabian Desert, Thar Desert in India, Atacama Desert and Patagonia Desert in South America, Great Australian Desert, Arizona Desert in USA, then the cold and temperate desert. You may have heard about the Gobi Desert in China. It is a temperate desert. Then there are Taklamakan Desert. Taklamakan Desert actually is in Central Asia. Then you will find in India also the portion of Ladakh. Now you'll find all these areas, they are having very, very sparsely populated. Population is very less. Even in India, you can find in Arunachal Pradesh also. Population is very less. Then some more example, like example of the cold polar regions, means the whole Arctic region in the north, Antarctica also. In fact, Antarctica is uninhabited. So there you will find only the scientists from the different countries. They are having the camp. Now why they, now they don't live for the whole year, only for 4 to 6 months during the summer season when temperature is less. And they used to go there for the research work. Then the equatorial rainforest, like the Amazon basin, all of you know this whole region is covered with the equatorial rainforest, equatorial forest. Then Congo basin, which is also called Zaire basin. So in fact, because these forests are very densely populated, forest. All of you know about the equatorial forest. They are very, very dense. And this is why population is very, very less. If you find example of Zaire, you will find there the only tribal people used to live there. There is one specific tribal people. They are called Pygmies. Now, because they have adapted themselves to live in this condition, and that's why only they can survive in these equatorial forest of Zaire. Same way in the Amazon basin also, Amazon forest, that there also you will find there is a specific tribal people. They are called Amazons. So they are found here. So we have seen here about the three main zone of population distribution. We have discussed about the densely populated regions in the world. Second, we have seen the moderately populated regions. And third, we have seen the sparsely populated region. Now here I want to show you, as I told you, that I would like to show you one now here is one data, one table here you can find. So here you can find the continent wise population is given here. And if you'll find here, this is Asia, Africa, Europe, Latin America and the Caribbean islands together, Northern America, that is North America, Oceania means Australia. Now here you will find this population is given here, and you can find here the largest population. Which continent is having the largest population? You can see here, Asia. Now you can find the second number is Africa, then Europe, then South America, then North America and Australia. Now here if you will find about the density of population, you will find the density of population in Asia is 144 people per square kilometer. Means when we take about the density, population density of Asia, so you will find in 1 square kilometer area, that density tells that 144 people used to live. But again, if you see here in Africa, now it becomes how much? So less, 42 person per square kilometer. In Europe, 33. Then in South America, 32. North America, it becomes 20. In Australia, it becomes 5. So this density, population density, tells about the, about, it gives a one clear picture about the population in the different continents. In fact, here this data is given in your book. Those who are having the book, you can just consult it in your book. And here you can find here the different datas, like population, that is up to 2017, yearly change in the population, net change, density means population density, area of the whole continent, migrants, fertility rate, then mortality rate, urban population. So all these things are given here. Now next we are going to see the next thing I'm going to explain you about. The next topic is factors affecting population density. So we are going to see about the which factors affects the population density. Now population density means Now, which factors affect the population density means positive way and the second negatively way, negative way. Positive means high density of population and low density of population. So let's see here. Already you can find here on your screen. Here the first factor is resource. How the resource can be an important factor. Now you all of you know the areas which is very very rich in minerals, which is very rich in the natural resource. So automatically you will find the population there is very high. Now example, the coastal area, you will find the coastal area is very very rich in the enormous fish found in the sea, and you will find population density also is very very high, and you will find most of the people actually are engaged in fishing business. Well, at the same time, there are so many things are there, not only the fishing, but in the coastal areas so many activities are carried. Now there coconut is found, large number of coconut trees. Coconut is used for so many things, so many purpose. Now let me just tell you some example. You must be knowing about some cities like Dhanbad, Tata Nagar, that is Jamshedpur, Ranchi, Raurkela in Odisha. Then there is a Bhilai city. Now all these cities, if you find the, you will just check the history of these cities. Just 20 years before, the population was very less. 30 years before or 40 years before, they were all covered with the forest region. But what happened? Because these regions, these all areas are very very rich in mineral. And so what happens? So many factories developed there. And what happened? So many large number of people, they migrated from the other state to these areas. And now at present, if you go there, like Ranchi or maybe Dhanbad, maybe Raurkela or Bhilai city, Durg. So all these cities actually, they have become not only very big cities, but also densely populated. So this is one example. We have seen that how the resources can develop any region into a high density or densely populated region. Next thing is the some example low density. Let's see here how the resources. Now there are so many places, like you will see the example of desert. Now desert, no resources there. Mostly, most of the desert actually, there is a lack of natural resources. And so the population, you can't find any people living there, because even a tree is not found, no water is found. So no resource and population is nil. Another factor is the climate. The climate, if you find here, there are some places where the climate is very good or moderate climate, you will find they are densely populated. So you, let's see example of the Europe. The whole Europe can be divided into two parts, Western Europe and Eastern Europe. In the Western Europe, population density is very high. Why the population density is very high? Because the climatic condition here is moderate, as the Western Europe lies near the coastal area. So there it has been influenced by the warm westerly winds and the warm ocean current, and that makes the climate there in the coastal area moderate, and this is why the population also is very dense. But in the Eastern Europe, because the climatic condition is very extreme, in winter it becomes very very cold, so they are having very very long winters even, and this is why population also is very less. Population density is very less. Another topic is the political condition. Now how the political condition? Now you can find here the countries where the government is stable, where the usually the government is democratic. So there you will find the population density also is very high. An example in India and in so many European countries, in so many American countries, you will find these all countries are having a stable government, and that's why even large number of people, they want to go, they want to go to these countries for the to work. But what happens, like example of Russia. Now Russia is having the communist government, and conditions are very hard. And you will find some more example of like Iran and Iraq. There also the political condition is not so good, and this is why nobody wants to go to these countries. And in fact, the number of people, they just want to migrate from there. One recent example, you can find example of Syria. Now just some year before, as this whole area was covered, it was captured by ISIS. And what happened? Large number of people, they migrated, they fled from these countries to the European countries, to Asia, to Africa, to America. Why? Because political condition is very unstable. Next topic is the social condition. Now social condition means where the people, they can enjoy their freedom, their rights. So the people, most of the people, they want to live and they want to go to those places where they enjoy the freedom of right, all types of rights, freedom. But nobody wants to go to the countries, like example, all of you must be knowing about North Korea. Now nobody wants to go to North Korea from the other countries. Nobody wants to go there. In fact, the people from the North America, they want to escape from there. So all of you knowing about that dictator Kim Jong-un, and the political condition is so bad, so worse. Next is the social. Okay, so this is the social condition. And the last one is the economic. Now let's see here about the economic. Now you'll find here, most of the people, if you'll find some of the dreams of some young people, and if you'll ask them, and if they're very ambitious, and you'll ask them, and they will tell you that they want to go to America to just get a better job, and in fact they want to just settle there, or maybe some European countries like UK, or maybe Spain or France, or maybe Italy. Why? Because these countries, they are having a developed economic stage, condition. Economically, they are very advanced, very highly developed. The economic condition is very good there. So these are some topics which affect the population density. One topic I have forgot to write here. One more topic is relief. Relief means the landforms, topography, you can say. Now what is the topography or landforms? Example, like mountainous region. Now mountains, you will find population density is very less. Now in plain region, because plain region is a very fertile land, and you will find the population very dense. Now next topic, we are going to see about the overpopulation. Now what is the meaning of overpopulation, and we are going to see the causes of overpopulation. So overpopulation means, as you can see here, too great population. Overpopulation, there are some countries actually, they are facing the problem of large population. So overpopulation means, this term actually, overpopulation, it means too great population for a specific region to support, or You can say in a common sentence, population crash or population explosion. So, impaired quality of life or a population crash. Why? Because of the big population. Now population there, because of the some condition, the population has become so large. Now this population is creating a problem. Like example, you can find so many examples, like in our country, India, China, Bangladesh, Malaysia, Indonesia, these countries, even in Pakistan. So all these countries, they are having a very, very big population, and this big, so large population itself have become a big problem. Well, now here, there are so many countries which are actually suffering from this overpopulation problem. Now we are going to see about the causes of overpopulation. What are the causes you can find here? The first cause is the decline in the death rate. Now what happens here, as you can find, now we are having the better medical facilities, better quality of life, now good quality of nutrition is provided by the government itself. You can see the example of in our villages, there are primary schools are there, and in these schools, usually, as all of you know, the children, the village, the rural people, means the village, the people, the children living in the rural areas, in the villages, so they are given the education. And here government actually has made one provision. Now all these students in these primary schools, they usually are provided with the midday meal, means the lunch. And government even want to just provide them a nutritious food. Why? Just to provide a good nutrition. Well, so this is how actually, because of all this thing, the death rate, which is also called mortality rate. So many countries, this death rate has gone down. And when the death rate has gone down, so population has increased. Many areas, they have become overpopulated. Second point is the better medical facilities. Now even in India, you know about the, now recently there is a one facility is been given there. This facility is the about the health condition. I'm not remembering it. What do you call it? This condition, the just recently our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has introduced it. Okay. Now, so every hospital, now you can find a better medical facility has been provided. Now those actually are having the money, right? Now they can avail the private hospitals. Now there the conditions are much better, right? So because of all these things actually, the death rate has declined, and so overpopulation. This is another cause. And third cause is the technological advancement in fertility treatment. There was a time actually when there are some people actually, when some parents, they face the problem of fertility, means they are unable to conceive the baby. But now actually, because of better medical science, medical facilities are available, and so they get the treatment. There is a one fertility treatment method is there, and by that method they get the babies, right? There are so many hospitals are there which helps especially in this area. So these are the points which are the main cause for the overpopulation. First is the decline in the death rate. Second is the better medical facilities. And third is the technological advancement in fertility treatment. Now next is we are going to see about the problem of, overpopulation. Now how this overpopulation is creating a problem? So first of all, the first problem which has been created by the overpopulation is the rapid growth, population growth. So as you can find, population is increasing day by day. Now in some areas, in some families we can find it is creating a problem, right? Now there is some underdeveloped countries like in Nepal, in Bangladesh. Bangladesh actually is underdeveloped countries, and you can find there this growing population is creating a big problem there. Now next is the unemployment. Now why so many large number of people, they don't get the job? There is a problem of unemployment. Why? Because of the overpopulation. Every year the population is increasing here, so the young people, as they need the job, but there is a lack of job, right? Next is the housing and health. Now this problem of overpopulation is also creating the problem of housing and health, because as the number of families is increasing, now they need the new house, new land to buy. And what happened? Now it is very, very difficult for them to get the new land, to buy a new house. You can take the example of our city, Gorakhpur. Just 20 years before, there were so many areas which was just agricultural land. Like our area, the whole Rapti Nagar and all those areas up to medical college, it was all agricultural land. But what happened? Now you can find the big colonies developed there. So why? Because of the overpopulation. So here the first three problems of the overpopulation is the rapid population growth, unemployment, and third is the housing and health. Third is we are going to see about the impacts of overpopulation. How the overpopulation it impacts, right? So first of all, the first impact is the, as you can see, depletion of natural resources. What are the natural resources? Water. Water is a natural resource. Air. Fresh air. Now you can find, because of the overpopulation, now cities are developing, becoming bigger and bigger. Number of vehicles are also increasing. And so pollution is increasing. Now as the pollution is increasing, it is creating a problem of fresh air. In past, you can already have seen so many news that what happened during the winter season, the pollution problem which has been faced there in Delhi, so many big cities, they are all facing the same problem, the problem of the pollution. So air is one natural resource. Another resource is water. Now you can find everybody, now we use that water either from the purifiers. Most of the houses you can find the water purifiers are there. So now we can't actually drink the water directly from the hand pump or from the tap. Why? Because even the water is polluted. Why the water is polluted? Because of the overpopulation. So this example I'm giving you some very common natural resources like water and air. Next is the environmental hazards. Just now I told you, increasing population is creating a environmental hazards. You may have studied about the global warming, or maybe you may be knowing about global warming, right? And population problem of pollution, which is increasing, air pollution. What is this? All these are the example of the environmental hazards. Same way, the climatic change which is taking place. Why? Because of the pollution. There are so many examples can be given. Now next is the unemployment and poverty. Now already we have seen, because the pollution, overpopulation, population is increasing, and it is creating a what? Which problem? Unemployment. So here the overpopulation is also impacting what thing? The employment. Unemployment and poverty is also increasing. Why? Because of this overpopulation. Next is the health and sanitation. There was a time actually 20 years back when, or 30 years before, in Gorakhpur only medical college and district hospital, only these were the only big hospitals, and railway hospital. And they We are able to provide the medical facilities to everybody. Why? Because the population in Gorakhpur was less. But now they are unable to provide the good medical facilities. Why? Because now in Gorakhpur, population have become triple or maybe four times bigger than 30 years back. And this is why you can find there are so many private nursing homes, hospitals are there. So, this is how the health, sanitation you can find as the new colonies they developed, but they were not developed a very planned way. No planning was done. Just the people, they bought the land and they built their houses, and afterwards Nagar Palika, they have built the drainage systems, and this is how what happened. In our city you can find the water logging is so common during the rainy season, and because of that, that is the sanitation. And so many colonies you can find there, the garbage actually is just thrown in some corner. So this is a sanitation problem. So this is how actually the overpopulation is also impacting the health and sanitation. Next is the imbalance in trade. Now, imbalance in trade, what is the meaning of imbalance in trade? Let me explain you here. Now, there are the two terms. One term we call it export. Another one is we call import. Now, what is export? Export means when from our country, from India, when we sell some companies or when the goods are sent to the other countries, or in a common language when we say that when India sell the good to other countries, that is called export. But when we buy the goods from other countries to our country, when the goods are brought to our country, we call it import. Now, what is export and what is import? Let me explain you. Export actually is a expenditure of any country. When we export anything, export means when we send the goods. So that time actually it is called the income of our country. Export actually is a income of our country, while import is a expenditure. So in a common way, suppose if any family it spends more than their income, what will happen? They will face the financial crisis. That is why every family, they create a budget, means they have to manage according to the salary or their income, whatever their income, monthly income is there, they get, and according to that they prepare one budget, because they have to see that their expenditure should be less than the income. So then only they will able to save some money. Well, the same condition is here in India, in not only India but all the countries. So when any countries, when the export is less than the import, what happened? Now they are in deficit, means they are in problem. Now what is their, what they are doing? They are spending more than their income. So usually all the countries, they usually check this thing that their export should be more than the import. Well, this is called imbalance in trade. When any country, it start importing more goods than what they export, so they see the imbalance in the trade and they start facing a problem. This is why most of the countries, they used to concentrate in one thing. They want to see their export increasing while import decreasing. Now that shows about the economic status of any country. So we can know any country is economically growing when their export is more than the import. So here the overpopulation, as all of you know, the number of people, the population as it increases. So what happened? Now more things means they need. So the country, they need to increase their import. So this is how the overpopulation also affect the imbalance in trade. So we have seen how the overpopulation impacts the some points. We have seen some areas. Number one, depletion of the natural resources. Natural resources is depleting. Why? Because of the overpopulation. Second, environmental hazards. They are all are the result of overpopulation. Unemployment and poverty also is a result of overpopulation. Bad health and bad sanitation, they are the result of overpopulation. And another one, imbalance in trade is also is the result of overpopulation. So today I think we should end the class because already it is 56 minutes, and next period, the next session, we are going to see about the underpopulation. So you can see here the topic underpopulation. Also I will tell you about the causes of, you will see the causes of underpopulation, problems of underpopulation and impacts of underpopulation, and we will try to finish the chapter. This chapter is lengthy, so today only up to this much. So here you can find here the picture also, this figure 2.7, you can see here, this is the one result of overpopulation. You can see this train, the whole train, and how this people, it is just overloaded. So this picture, where you can find this picture? You can find in India. Well, so all of you, your homework is to read this chapter. Those who are having the book, your homework is to read the whole second chapter. And another one, to you have to find out the answer of the first chapter. And very soon I will provide you the notes and the given homework also. You can upload it from the school websites. Okay. All the best. Goodbye.